John, it's hard to believe that the moment of truth is only a couple of weeks away. It's not long before you'll be officially ordained as a permanent deacon. What's going through your mind right now as you start this new chapter in your life?
Well, I think I'm excited to be starting a chance to serve, I think, because I love my parish. I love the people in my parish. I kind of like everything about the church, so it was a great experience, a chance to learn so many new things, and now to put them into practice and to assist at the Mass, and to be kind of a closer friend maybe to the people I know, and maybe of a different type of service than I could have been in the past. You know, as far as whatever they need help with, as far as the sacraments, or just as a companion throughout the week, or throughout the month, or throughout the year. But maybe just to have a little closer relationship with the people that I've known for so long, but now it'll be in a different role.
Looking back a few years ago, why did you decide to answer this call to the diaconate program?
Well, I had actually read about the diaconate program probably 10 years before I had even considered applying. So we didn't have a permanent deacon at our parish. So I was kind of new to it, but I wanted to find out as much as I could about it. So a lot of it appealed to me. A lot of the service appealed to me. And it was just a coincidence that before the actual time came for the application to the diaconate, I was actually approached by about three different people to say, have you ever considered the diaconate? And I said, yes, I have. And sure enough, a week later, something else, and another person a week later. So I said, well, maybe this is some kind of a sign that I should try it. So I said, well, let me apply and see how things go. And I applied, and I found out a little more about it and everything about it. The whole experience has been wonderful. I couldn't ask for more.
John, one of the great privileges of being a deacon is that you will have the opportunity to connect with faithful on so many different levels through so many different ministries. Is there any one ministry in particular that you're looking forward to?
Well, I've been involved with social concerns for probably about 10 years now. So as far as the welfare of others, the elderly, possibly helping the elderly, going to the people that can't make it to the Mass because they're homebound, or possibly helping families out that maybe are having a tough go of it, you know, that maybe they're struggling with anything that I could be of assistance with. I'm lucky I have a wonderful marriage to a great woman, so maybe I could give some tips on that, or I have a wonderful son, so, and I love being a father and a husband, so anything related to family life, maybe I could give some background on my experience just to show that, you know, there are tough times, no matter what your vocation is, your avocation, so you just have to bear through it, you know, with prayer and with God's help, we could get through anything. So I think in that regard, I could possibly give some of my opinions and some of my experience, share my experience with others to let them know that, yeah, there are tough times, but they pass. You just have to have faith in God, and he'll get you through it.
When you think about this formation program that you just went through, how do you think it's assisted you in your own journey of faith?
Well, the first thing I would say is the opportunity to learn has been spectacular. The teachers at the parish, at the diocesan level, wonderful priests, and they're extremely intelligent, and you can learn so much from them. So that alone was worth the price of admission. But just the chance to be involved and to interact with other people who might have had the same viewpoint as you, so you found points of commonality between all these different men, and you find out that, you know, a lot of the experiences you've had, you've shared them with the men, even though you haven't met them until you actually started the program. But the faith experiences kind of overlap, and they dovetail a little bit. So altogether, it's been a wonderful experience. I would recommend it to anyone. It's a great formation experience. You learn so much. There's so much to learn about the faith. It's incredibly deep, but it's very approachable. And the teachers here have been wonderful. The priests have been wonderful. I couldn't ask for a better experience.
John, you already touched upon this when you were talking about your wife and your son and how those experiences as a husband and a father will assist you. But as you reflect about your experiences in the business world and your experiences with your family, how do you think that will enhance your role as a deacon?
Well, everything's different. So if you're in the work world, things are kind of a little, a lot of people don't want to be there, right? So the experiences are completely different. Whereas if you go to Mass, people, the people want to be there. So the attitudes of people are completely different at different locations and different jobs and different vocations. But I think just with your attitude, you can influence others. If you could always keep a positive attitude, you know, if you could always look on the optimistic side of things and kind of counsel people if they are having tough times, or just say, well, I've been through that, you know, I've done that, things will get better. You just have to bear up to it. If you're a person of prayer, prayer is the greatest answer in the world. You know, put your cares in God's hands, and He'll take care of it. So that's what I tell people.